Subscribe to my YouTube channel, that is Teacher Kirwa. There are more videos there, you can find them for yourself. So I want to take this opportunity to officially welcome you to today's Chemistry Wednesday. So today we are going to look at Organic Chemistry 2, have we progressed from Organic Chemistry 1. So we've had a number of lessons for Organic Chemistry 1 discussing on alkanols, alkenes and alkynes. That those are, we say they are called hydrocarbons. So today we are going a notch higher and we are doing Organic Chemistry 2, which consists of alkanols. We also have here, we have alkanoic acids. We after alkanoic acids we'll talk of detergents. So you keep staying around, we'll talk about soaps and detergents, and then thereafter we discuss polymers. And we shall be done with the organic chemistry. So this is a topic of Form 4 Organic Chemistry. One is in Form 3. This is a Form 4 topic, and we are going to cover it right here, and right now, and for the next few lessons. In the coming weeks. So let's look at alkanols. Now alkanols are a group of organic compounds which contain, these are compounds containing carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. So when we were looking at Organic Chemistry 1, we only said they are hydrocarbons and they consist of carbon and hydrogen only. So in this instance now, we are adding oxygen, another atom that adds to these two. When you proceed with this, you will also add nitrogen here, you will also add fluorine, and the others, that is in colleges. So alkanols are compounds that consist of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. And so because there is hydrogen and oxygen, then they have hydroxyl group that is OH. So they have hydroxyl group. This one you call it either hydroxyl, some of us may say hydroxide, it is still the same thing. So they have a hydroxide group as a functional group. Called OL. Okay, this is a functional group called OL. You remember, we talked about functional group, double bond and triple bond. And we said a functional group is a group of atoms which is responsible for the chemical properties of a compound. So this is OH, it is called the ol, which is responsible for the chemical properties of alkanols, as we shall look at a later stage. So they have OH as a functional group. The general formula for all the alkanols is CN, H2N plus 1, and then OH. The general formula for this alkanol series, this is another homologous series of compounds. So the general formula for this homologous series is CN, H2N plus 1, and then OH, where we said N refers to the number of carbon atoms. So N is the number of carbon atoms, so that if you have, for example, N is equal to 1, if we have N is equal to 1, then this one will be C1, and then H is 2 times 1, which is 2, and then plus 1 is 3, and then OH. Okay, so these are, that is how we write the formulas. We shall look at that. Now we can say also that alkanols are derivatives of water. Derivatives of water. Where one hydrogen is replaced by an alkyl. So these are derivatives of water, where one hydrogen in water. All of us know that the formula of water is H2O. Now, if the formula of water is H2O, you realize we have two hydrogens and one oxygen. So now we are replacing the, for example, this is HOH. Okay? Now, to get an alkanol, you replace the H with an alkyl. Okay? Remember in our last lesson, in our last topic, we discussed about an alkyl, and we said an alkyl is a hydrogen short of an alkene. So that if you have CH4, we say this one is called methane. Okay? This is methane. But now, if you reduce one hydrogen so that you have CH3, that is called a methyl. And so we have CH4 is methane, and then CH3 is methyl. Similarly, ethane. So we are replacing the H with an alkyl. So in this case, we have replaced H with a CH3, so that we now have CH3OH. So we are replacing that H. So that is why we are saying they are derivatives of water. So let's look at preparation for the nomenclature of alkanols. Nomenclature and isomerism. Let me combine both of them. Nomenclature and isomerism. Now, nomenclature is naming of organic compounds, as we said, as we looked at in the other discussions that we did. And then we have isomerism. Isomerism, we said, is different existence of different compounds of an element in the same physical state. So we have no different existence. Isomerism is the existence of compounds with the same molecular formula but different structural formulas. So these ones are named alkanols. Are named by replacing the suffix E in alkenes with ol. So alkanol nouns are damned by replacing the suffix "-e". Okay? When we were looking at alkenes, we say they end with the suffix "-e". And then they are replaced with the suffix "-ol". For example, methane. We can just name a few examples of alkenes. One is methane. So, e.g. Methane. So, methane ends with E. Now, we are replacing the E with ol. Then we have methanol. So, this one becomes methanol. Okay? Even. Another example. Replace E with ol becomes ethanol. Okay? Propane becomes, replace E with ol becomes propanol. And so on. Butanol, pentanol, etc. So they are named by replacing the E in alkenes with ol. This ol is the functional group OH. So that is how alkanols are named. Now, if we look at a few examples of this, so the first member of the alkanol series is methanol, which contains carbon number 1. So if n is equal to 1, if n is equal to 1, we have said the general formula is CnH2n plus 1 and then OH. So if n is equal to 1, then you will have Cn is C1. So C1 you don't write 1. So we have C and then H will be 2 times 1 plus 1, which is 3, and then OH. Okay? So this one is called methanol. We also have number 2. If n is equal to 2, then we take C2, so we have Cn2, and then H will be 2 times 2 plus 1, which is 5. So C2, H5, and then OH. Because C is equal to 2, then it is called ethanol. ETC. Number 3, N is equal to 3. You have C3, H7, OH. This one is called propanol. All the way up to decanol. Decanol is n is equal to 10. So what about if n is equal to 10? So it is CCN, which is C10. And then H 2 times 10 is 20. Plus 1 is 21. Okay? So that is CN, C10, H21. And then OH. So because we have C10, you remember dec. So this one is called decanol from decan. So that is how alkanols are named and how they are written. So we can look at the structural formula. So if we have C, maybe let me just draw two structural formulae and then you can do the rest. So let me do C2H5OH. So we have two carbons, that is 1, 2, and then 5 hydrogen. So you remember we were filling the remaining bonds with hydrogen. So you have 1 here, 2, 3, 4. This side is 1, 2, 3, 4. So the last one is OH. That's how you draw. So C3, what about C3, H7OH? So this is ethanol. We have said this is ethanol. We have C3 is propanol. So propanol C3, you have 1, 2, 3. Okay? And then you have 7 hydrogens. So 1, 2, 3, 4. This 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 1, 2, 3, and 4. The only difference with the alkenes is that we are replacing one hydrogen with the OH. So that makes it that. Now another way of writing this formula, this is C2H5OH. Another way of writing it, you can say you have two carbons, one, two, and then hydrogens, you have in total, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you have 6 hydrogens, and then you have 1 oxygen. Okay, this one is C3H. H is 3, 5, 7, 8, this 7 and then 8. So you have 8 and then O. So sometimes you can write it either this way or that way, depending on how you like it. So that is how alkanols are named and drawn. So you can draw the rest of the structures. Now they also exhibit about isomerism now. Alkanols exhibit two types of isomerism. And we mentioned this just as you. So just as in alkenes and alkynes, they exhibit two types of isomerism. And these are, as we said, positional and branching. Positional isomerism and branching isomerism. As we said, positional isomerism refers to the position of the functional group. And then branching isomerism refers to the position and the type of the branch. So for example, let us say we have these two compounds. You will realize that both of them are C3H7OH. They have the same molecular formula. So the same molecular formula, structural formulas are different. In this first one, you realize that now always when we are numbering, as we looked at the others, alkenes and alkynes, when you are numbering, you begin with the end that is closer to the functional group. So when we are numbering this compound, our number one carbon is there because that's where we have the functional group. So 1, 2, 3. This one, you can start from either side. It can be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Still, OH is at carbon number 2. So there's no problem. So 1, 2, 3. Now, they are same molecular formula. The difference is the position of the functional group. In this first one, the functional group is at carbon number 1, OH. And you remember we have said OH is the all. Okay? So this one, the name of this, we have 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. So 3 is propan. So we call it propan 1-ol. Propan 1-ol. To say the all is at carbon number 1. Now, in the second one is propan 2-ol. Because OH is at carbon number 2. So that is how we name. So these two are referred to as positional isomers. These two are positional isomers because they have the same molecular formula but different structural formulas, in the sense that the functional group here is at carbon number 1, the functional group here is at carbon number 2. So those are positional isomers. Another example. Another example is this. Okay, so in this one, both of them are C4H9OH. The difference also is the position of the functional group. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, when we were doing alkenes, when you start from this end, you will have 1, 2, 3. The OH will be at carbon number 3. On this other side, the OH is at carbon number 2. So we take the position where the functional group is at the lowest number possible. So this one is 1, 2. So 2 only. Now, so giving it the name, this one will be, because we have 4 carbons, then it is butane. So we call it butanol. It is a butanol, but the ol is at carbon number 1. This one is called butanol. Okay, so these are positional isomers of butanol. We have butanol and butanol, and so on and so forth. Now, let me give a different example. We have, let us draw. Let us draw 3-methyl-butan-2-ol. Now, when we were doing this kind of drawing, we said we always have two parts of an isomer. We have the parent name and we have the branch. So the parent name here is butan-2-ol. It means we have 4 carbons from bute and then we have OH at carbon number 2. So, butan-2-ol, you draw 4 carbon atoms first. Butanol. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. That is bute. Then, at carbon number 2, you have OH. So, at carbon number 2, 1, 2 here, you have an OH there. You can start from this other side, 1, 2, you put OH there. Okay, so at carbon number 2, we have OH. So, we are done with the parent. Okay, we are done with the parent. Now, come to the branch. At carbon number 3, so we know that this carbon number 1, 2, 3, 4. So at carbon number 3, we have a methyl branch. So carbon number 3 here, we have a methyl. You remember methyl is CH3. So we have a CH3 here. You let it open. So this is a CH3 at carbon number 3. Now, you realize there is no other business. Okay, so there is no other business. You complete the bonds using hydrogen. So here you have, for this carbon you have 1, so 2, you make it 4. 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. Okay, so the thing is 3-methyl, carbon number 3-methyl, and then butan-2-ol, the long chain containing OH at carbon number 2. So that's isomerism and how the compounds are named. You only need to consider that when you are determining the parent chain, it is the longest chain containing the OH, the functional group. So that is isomerism and nomenclature. We cannot exhaust isomerism and nomenclature. There are so many of them. So it's only that we do a few examples and then you keep on looking at the rest. So let me look at preparation of alkanol. Preparation of alkanol. Preparation of ethanol. We are using ethanol to represent all the other alkanols. So this, they have a common method of preparation. You remember when we were looking at organic chemistry 1, we talked about homologous series and we say that homologous series is a group of compounds which have the same method of preparation, inclusive in those. They have a general method of preparation applicable to all the members of that series. They also have the same chemical properties and a gradual change in physical properties. So when we say preparation of ethanol, we can as well say preparation of propanol is a common process. So this is in the lab. So number one, there are about three methods. Method one is what we said in our previous discussion for alkenes. So the first method of preparing alkanols is by method of preparing alkanols is by hydrolysis of now because it is ethanol, is hydrolysis of ethene. Hydrolysis was the opposite of dehydration. So this is when you have ethene, C2H4, it undergoes hydrolysis in the presence of Cox sulfuric 6 acid, reacting with Cox sulfuric 6 acid, and then we have water and we have warm. It is warmed. So when this happens, then you have ethanol, C2H5OH. So this one undergoes hydrolysis. You remember when we were drawing this compound, we said sulfuric 6 acid, which is in our previous discussion, breaks down so that you have this step. This is a two-step reaction where sulfuric 6 acid reacts with ethene to form ethyl hydrogen sulfate. You can refer to what we did. And then that ethyl hydrogen sulfate, water is added and then warmed, and you have ethanol. So this is one of the ways of preparing alkanols two is on a large scale. Reaction of ethene and steam. So ethene is reacted with steam on a large scale to have an alkanol. For example, C2H4 reacting with steam. Steam is the gaseous form of water. Then you have C2H5OH. Now this one you undergoes the conditions at a temperature of 300 degrees Celsius and a pressure of 70 atmosphere pressure. So that is there was another compound here, another product. So it forms ethanol these are two step reaction. We said alkene, this is ethene, it forms the before this it forms C2 Now, this compound here is the intermediate product here. So, the intermediate product, this is what we call ethyl hydrogen sulfate. Hydrogen sulfate. Just for clarity. So the sulfuric 6 acid breaks down into hydrogen and this part, which is HSO4. So this called hydrogen, ethyl hydrogen sulfate, which when you add water and warm, then it forms alkanol, the ethanol compound there. So those are, this is now on a large scale, that is how alkanols are prepared. The alkanol prepared in this manner may not be very pure, so it undergoes distillation. Now, the third one is one that is always done at home. This is fermentation. Okay, fermentation. Kama uliishi na gogo, and then you saw them doing some fractional distillation of some pots arranged in a funny manner, together with torn and written away pieces of clothes, then you are aware of fermentation. Fermentation is a biological process by which a microorganism breaks down sugar. For example, the microorganism that we normally use by, that is normally used by a gogo, is the mermere. Okay, you know the mermere? The wimbi. Is it the wimbi or mutama? Ile imemea. So hiyo ndio inaitwa mermere. So that is the one that breaks down sugar into alkanol. So we have sugar is C6H12O6. So it's broken down by yeast to have C2H5OH and carbon 4 oxide gas. So this is the how alkanols are prepared at homes. This is what we take. You are aware of that. So that is it. To remove carbon 4 oxide, it can be removed by using sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide. So this is how alkanols are prepared in the lab. Physical properties. Physical properties. One of the physical, we'll just mention them first, because we have done some of this. Now, alkanols are soluble in water. They are soluble in water due to presence of hydrogen bonds. Hydrogen bond, as we said in Form 2, is a bond that is formed between between hydrogen and a more electronegative atom like oxygen. So because it has OH, because of the presence of OH, then we have hydrogen bonds in alkanols. So this OH is the one that gives it the hydrogen bonds. Now, any substance that contains hydrogen bonds, as we said in our discussion of structure and bonding, is that it is a polar substance. And any polar substance dissolves in water, which is a polar solvent. So they are soluble in water. Number two, they have... okay, maybe on solubility, we can just add a point that solubility decreases. Solubility decreases with increase in molecular mass. I hope you can see those handwritings. Solubility decreases with increase in molecular mass. For example, let me find a now, looking at this, we have just mentioned a series. So, if I use this as an example, methanol is more soluble in water compared to propanol. So solubility decreases with the increase in molecular mass. So as you go down, in short, as we go down the series from methanol, ethanol, propanol until decanol, the solubility decreases because of the increase in the number of bonds. So as this chain, you know, when you say methanol, it is C1. Ethanol is C2. So as the chain increases, as the alkyl chain increases, then solubility in water decreases. So number two, they have higher melting and boiling points than their corresponding alkanes. They have higher melting and boiling points compared to their corresponding alkanes. And the reason for this is because due to presence of hydrogen bonds in addition to weak van der Waals forces. So in addition to weak van der Waals forces of attraction, they have hydrogen bonds which are relatively hard to break. They are relatively strong. So that's why they have higher melting and boiling points compared to alkanes of the same kind. Okay. We are almost winding up. In some 2-3 minutes, we shall have done all. So, in addition to melting and boiling points, we can also say melting and boiling melting and boiling points increases down the series. So melting and boiling points increases down the series due to increase in the molecular formula of the compound, molecular mass of the compound. Of course, the rest, the others, we know that they are this number three. They have a characteristic order. Mnajua vile pombe inanuka. So that's a characteristic order. I don't know whether it is a sweet smell or it is not a sweet smell. You know better. So they have a characteristic order. They are colorless. So those are the physical properties that we can mention. The rest you can still find out for yourselves. So what we'll do next, but is not in this particular lesson, is the chemical properties. So in our next Chemistry Wednesday, we are going to look at the chemical properties of alkanols, the reactions that alkanols undergo. So up to that point, I hope I wish to put a full stop there, and then we pick up from here in our next lesson. So I want to take this time once again to say thank you for all viewers who have tuned in. Thank you for all viewers also who will tune in when we are off live. Later on, we shall avail this video in the YouTube. I've said my YouTube channel is Teacher Kirwa. So go to that channel, subscribe, put on the bell so that anytime I put a video there, you can be able to see. Also, like and share, and we help each other to grow. Otherwise, I want to say thank you so much. I want to give special thanks to Honorable Mutai. He has been a great fan for the last few weeks. So thank you, and God bless you so much. See you next time. Remember to keep it here. Bye-bye.